Well, hello there. I hope to see you again soon.
Attention, attention. Please handle relics carefully. In case of damage, your life will be forfeit.
Good day. Well, hello there. I hope to see you again soon.
Howdy.
The highway leading to C-12 Nashville is blocked by an anomalous storm, and you're forced to detour over a mountain pass. Soon, the radiator boils over, and you have to stop. Clara lifts up the hood and thoroughly examines the steaming radiator.
The engine's boiling, so we'll have to wait. You do know what happens when a car boils, right?
The blue shuts her mouth abruptly and stares anxiously at the dark funnel cloud dancing on the horizon. Now that you're on higher ground, it's clear that the storm has overtaken a fairly large section of road. It will be difficult to pass. The blue looks at the engine again.
We wait. As soon as it cools down, we'll go. This storm worries me more, but it's not an insurmountable problem. I heard there are some relics at the local gas station that protect against anomalies. You could even accidentally step on one out here, they say. Mysterious are the ways of the Lord.
Your companion perks up a bit. She seems to be interested in this subject.
This place is registered as a resource anomaly zone. Do you know what that is? It's when the relics mined there have been studied and deemed useful.
The blue looks at the storm once more.
There have been more and more of these lately, and they're getting stronger. I personally think it's divine judgment for how we've squandered the riches under the dome.
She sighs and squirms.
I knew people who got caught in one of those storms. They blow up so fast, there's no chance to get away. God rest their souls.
The blue makes the sign of the cross. Morgan thinks for a moment.
It's a combination cafe gas station called Roadside Picnic. Never been there myself, but there's something off about it. There are several anomalies around there and weird relics. Supposedly, machines and structures decay much faster than they should in that area. But maybe that's just a story.
Hello.
come back again.
Why should we depend on rational knowledge? Reason leads us up a blind alley over and over again.
A weird, scruffy old man with a matted beard is sitting in front of the checkout terminal. The badge on his blue jumpsuit is long since bleached away. The name Aaron Melville is written there in black marker. With a groan, he picks up a magnifying glass and, peering through it, begins poking at the keyboard with one knobby finger. The old man angrily sets the magnifying glass aside.
A grandmaster? You're a piece of junk, not a grandmaster. And a cheater to boot.
He raises his head to squint in your direction.
Eh? What do you want? I don't advise eating here, and there's nothing to buy.
The old man frowns and sniffles loudly.
You want to write a complaint? Go ahead.
He looks at you for a minute. When he realizes you're not going to complain, the surly expression slowly leaves his face. The angry look turns to a sad one. After a brief pause, he speaks again.
Yeah, well, I do have some problems.
The old man lowers his voice almost to a whisper.
The oranges pick on me. Escapees, by the look of it. They demand food, money, gas. I've got a turret at the entrance, but it doesn't do no shit. My stand-in screwed something up with the circuitry in the basement. I'll take a look when I get a chance. But with my leg acting up, those rickety stairs just ate my cup of tea. So here I am, sitting and playing chess, waiting for those bastards to come back.
Melville's getting grim again. He adds,
it's my business, and you'd best stay out of it. But if you want to, here's the key. Go down to the basement and see if you can do something with the generator. Maybe you could get the turret to work. That'd make things easier.
The old man throws up his hands with a scowl.
Oh, then go fix it.
Melville reluctantly points a crooked finger at the front door.
Go out there and walk over to the gas station. Go down to the basement. There's an anomaly, a tree. It's glowing. And there are some golden thingies hanging off it. We make special devices from that fruit called anomaly protectors. Should one be laying around on the floor, go grab it, then put it in the truck and bug off to... Where was it you was going to? That's where you bug off to.
The blue starts slapping the pockets on his overalls. After a little digging, he pulls out a little key on a shoelace.
Only take the device, you hear? It's company property. I should be charging you myself, as a matter of fact.
Uh-huh. And so is his temper.
The old man sits at the counter with his head propped in one hand.
No food, no supplies. The coffee is horse shit. Get out of here.
How should I know?
You came in and sat down. Ask them yourself.
The old man sniffs, annoyed.
Get some noodles from the vending machine there.
The old man sits at the counter with his head propped. The old man squints and gives you a silly smile.
Huh, so it's like that. Well, thank you, thank you. I didn't think you'd be any good.
Listen, Robbie, that dust storm? Am I hallucinating or is it really sort of weird?
It's but a measure of our ignorance.
Greetings.
Yeah.
Have a good one.
Thank you.
Your mothers are remarkable women. But you turned out to be a bunch of failures.
Melville agitatedly examines the blue car through the dusty glass.
Hey, what? How did they... They already barged in.
The old man gestures broadly.
This is a gas station, sweetheart. Try rummaging around. But don't you touch the dumpsters. I'm...
Come on, don't be shy.
I'm gonna rip you a new one.
Idiots, we're getting shot.
Annihilator, stop the attack. Annihilator, stop the attack.
Give up now.
What's wrong with you, huh?
Distract them.
Aim for the head, brain.
Asshole.
Someone shoot them already.
Arr!
Smack you up.
Oh,
Well, you seem like...
With his gang problem solved, Melville is visibly more hospitable.
I'm sorry for bitching at you, sweetheart. My mood hasn't been great this last couple of weeks. Would you like some coffee? As I could do.
The old man takes off his plastic leg and wraps it on the counter.
Hey, anybody want some coffee? Coffee, come on.
You can't tell if Aaron is coughing or laughing.
Well, it's seething with life. People come and go. White wingers hanging around the swamp. One such fella came along today, walking around poking things with that scanner of his. Doesn't shake hands with people. What kind of guy is that?
The old man leans close and continues in a confidential tone.
I used to have a gizmo of sorts. It warmed stuff up better than any heater. And when they saw it, their eyes almost bugged out of their heads. They took it away from me. It's dangerous, they say. What else? Well, sometimes bandits show up. Get pounded on the head occasionally. Not as often as I'd like, but there it is.
The old man gives you a smile of satisfaction. The old man scrubs his balls.
That'd be my stand-in, I think. And here I reckon he'd gone and quit on me. Could smell the stench from the cellar. Thought a rat croaked down there.
Listening to your story, he shakes his head in amazement.
You say it didn't even look like a person? Ooh, I had a bad feeling about this place from the start. Not good at all, I'm telling you.
The blue grunts like a goose.
Well, I cook for myself here. It's, you know, an acquired taste.
The old man sighs in sadness.
What life? I'm an old man. Life? My ass. Hey, sweetheart! Wait a minute! Hold up!
The blue claps you on the arm. He looks a bit confused.
I was just, I was thinking... I wanted to thank you. Maybe we could go on a picnic. You like picnics, don't you?
Aaron smiles. His expression is both silly and sincere.
Look, there's a cliff nearby. Lovely place. I got a cook pot already there. A comfy piece of tarpaulin, too. And the logs are alive. Even got little bottles.
Melville grunts, reaches under the counter, and pulls out a bulky bag smelling of onions. The old man lays out the bag's contents on the counter. Canned pork, onions, eggs, and potatoes.
What's a picnic without snacks? Here, I'm gonna teach you my family recipe for pulled pork. First, you have to boil the eggs, and then...
Gesturing excitedly, the old man reveals the secrets of Melville family cuisine.
I'd cook it myself, but I'm sure you can do better. See the stove behind me? There you go.
Aaron stares into his screen. He notices you.
Ah!
Squinting skeptically, Aaron... He lowers his voice.
There's that guy with a rock. The white by the swamp. And those two hippies. Ask them if they want sickles, too. If you got anybody else in mind, call them, too. More people, more fun.
Or maybe some forefather stuff? Why do you even care, honey?
Oh, good day. Have a good one.
Oh, hello there. I hope to see you again soon.
Salutations. Have a good one.
Listen, Rabbi, that dust storm? Am I hallucinating or is it